warm them up.
This place must move on.
up, everybody? Welcome back in for BSCW on a Friday night. Friday makeup tips night. Gonna make up for, did I see your game suggestion? Yes, I did. It's been a week. So we had to postpone Darkest Dungeon Tuesday because the new PC is built. It's awesome. I'm still streaming from the old one, but there'll be a lot of PC games coming your way. And then last night, I really do apologize. Skinja can vouch for me. It was a cluster at work. So, it was necessary to postpone simply because I didn't want to have the thing happen at work, happen right in the middle of the broadcast, and have to like pause everything and leave you guys hanging. So here we are tonight. 7 matches. Got 3 belts on the line. The first time outside of pay-per-view that the Women's Mixer Chat Championship is actually being contested based off tributes. And I think it's important for me to stop and explain to the women's division that you have to use the challenge command just like the men do and spend 1,000 tributes now to challenge for Women's Mixer Chat Championship. So you have up until 6 p.m. Eastern Time Thursday each week to challenge. The first 6 get in. There are 2 challengers tonight to take on Mads, and that will be the second to last event. There are only 3 title matches tonight. As always, after the pay-per-view, we don't challenge any of the belts that people kind of won in the run-up. They get to enjoy them for at least a week. So we have Mixer Chat Championship, Women's Mixer Chat Championship, and Hardcore Stalltar tonight. And on that note, we need 6 volunteers or 5 volunteers for Hardcore Stalltar, so put your hands in the air right now if you want to be in Hardcore Stalltar main event against Squirrel. Dustin, the only one? Anybody else want in a Hardcore Stalltar match tonight? Just Dustin, huh? Fixer's gonna start typing Dr. Death. These pandas are here to party. Anyone else want in? I'm gonna start raising my hand. Fixer's in. Usually wait a minute. Anyone else want in Hardcore Stalltar tonight? Going once. If you have a wrestler in BOCW, you can get in Hardcore Stalltar by simply doing the hand raise gesture in chat. Nope. On Thursday nights or Friday nights, Money Man will just raise your hand. Go once. Hardcore Stalltar, hands in the air, going twice. Money Man will. Anyone else? Hardcore Stalltar, Sweet Dave. There we go.
You will endure this loss.
I knew people would eventually get in. And Dave. Alright, so let's get that set up right now. Because you guys took forever. First person to raise their hand tonight was Odd Dustin. You actually get to see what Money Manuel's guy looks like here in the menu. There's Dustin. Number 2 was Dr. Death. Number 3 was me. Number 4 was Money Manuel. Hey, well, that's not an excuse, Dave. Number 5 is Sweet Dave. And defending champion. Party time. That's cool, dude. I get it. Friday's not the normal night. I have to get the show in before Sunday, and this is the only shot I've got to do that. So let's get a title on. This will be for Hardcore. Hello, Hardcore Stalltar. And then we'll fire up the show and get going. Make sure that looks right here. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Dustin, Dr. Dash, Fixer, Squirrel, Sweet Dave, Money Man. Well, that is right. Yep. All right, let's go. Let's start the show. There's your first set of debuts tonight. Little Dirty Hamster and Money Man will kicking the show off in their very first matches in BSCW. Here we go. New music post Kesselmania. Weston Wolf, what's up, man? Best setup real quick while we're loading in. Yeah, it says Thursday. I wasn't changing the whole thing around. set up, ready to go. Turn that down. That's super loud. Let's see that. So, BSCW back in action post Castlemania. Here we go. First match of the night coming your way. Dirty Little Hamster on your left. Money Manuel on the right. Place your bets. You got 1 minute and 30 seconds. Starting right now. Max is 250. Hopefully the weekend kicks off good for everybody. I know I have a great weekend planned. I'm really, really, really looking forward to tomorrow. Yep, untried, untested, about to break. No, actually, I'm booking my kids' plane tickets to come see me in July. By the way, there will be no streams the week of July 9th. My sons will be here, so that'll be an off week. Arrived on the dance floor. Jamal, what's up? But I will make sure there's an announcement more formally placed for that. But here we go. First match of the night. You got 30 seconds left of your bet window. Little Dirty Hamster is your first option. Money Manuel, option number two. And here they go, coming down to the ring. That is a veiny, veiny dude. Betting closed. Money Manuel taking home the most bets. About 600 tributes on the line in this match. Or delay. Little Dirty Hamster with his custom caw and that tattoo work on his back looks freaking awesome. Getting in the ring for his first ever BOCW match. And he is going to be taking on fellow newcomer Money Manuel. Money Manuel, your music choice, I made a decision based on tempoing and kept a harder sound. There he is, Money Manuel, making his way into BOCW in style. And on his way down to the ring to take on Little Dirty Hamster. There's some freaky ass characters debuting tonight, just put it that way. It's the ring. Just need a TV to crawl up. Thanks for the nightmares, Jeep. Look at that crowd interaction. That's pretty sick. Sorry, I'm watching it. I like the intro. Dream Jar releases 10 tributes. Yeah, it's a long intro. It's okay, though. Uh-oh. He's doing weird stuff, that's for sure. And here we go, Little Dirty Hamster, Money Manuel, facing off to start BOCW Friday Makeup Tips. Money Manuel gets the Little Dirty Hamster first. It looks like he's going to get, yeah, there it is, the counter. And up he goes. Little Dirty getting the reversal and putting Money Manuel down the canvas. Hamster goes right back to work, knee to the face on Manuel, sends it back to the ropes. And the Gutbuster drops Money Manuel down to the canvas. Little Dirty Hamster stands tall over him. The thing with the top rope says, Kaze, what's up, man? Off the whip, and there's the sweep reversal from Money Manuel, putting their little hamster down on the canvas, and outside the ring he goes. I thought Carney was flashy. Well, you ain't seen nothing yet. Money Manuel going for the apron, looking for something underneath. The Dirty Little Hamster cuts him off, lifting him up and slamming him down by the announcer's table. Well, Little Dirty Hamster has gotten the best of this to start. There's a lot of syllables in that name. I have to come up with a short way of saying it. Little Dirty Hamster, LDH. That'll work. There it is. Money Manuel thrown in the barricade, and LDH stays right on him. Little Ham Ham. And look at that throw all the way from the wall. Puts Money Manuel back in the ring, and the chair comes with LDH. Let's go. Dirty Little Hamster in the chat, seeing his wrestler debut in BOCW. Off the ropes he goes, and Money Manuel drops him down on a nasty twist off the whip. But he gets reversed, standing back up. The shoulder drops Money Manuel down. This keeps going back and forth. The counter from his back, kick to the face, drops the hamster down. He's rolling outside like he needs a nap, but he's right on his feet. Money Manuel celebrates in the ring. They celebrated a little bit too long. Dirty Little Hamster just grabs him and tosses him behind him and goes right back to work, putting the boot into his chest on the mat. Who's a rapper? Not me. Well, I was saying LDH because Little Dirty Hamster's a lot of syllables for play-by-play call. Pin attempt from Money Manuel. A little Dirty kicks out of that quickly. Money Manuel goes right back to work. Off the ropes, reverses it, and the chop drops him off the whip reversal. And again, Money Manuel celebrates in the corner as Dirty Hamster gets back to his feet.
Scrubcore welcomes you.
Peace Rebellion re-following. Thank you very much. Little Dirty lines him up. Money Manuel getting back to his feet. What's going to happen here? Oh, he stole that one from Fixer, didn't he? The spear drops Money Manuel down. And the pin attempt on Money Manuel from Little Dirty Hamster. Money Manuel kicks out of that one. Little Dirty Hamster can't believe it. Thought he had it done. Lining him up again. Oh, look at this. It's a jackhammer. You're stealing my signature now, too. Puts Money Manuel down with the jackhammer. I don't know if I like this very much. Another pin attempt coming. Dr. Death losing 18 tributes to the monster as Money Manuel kicks out of another pin from that jackhammer. The big power bomb puts the monster Money Manuel down to the canvas again. A little Dirty's in control, rolling him over. Going for a pin again. That's all right. Money Manuel quickly kicking out after a one count. Now the hold being put on from behind, getting the neck twisted. And there it is. Money Manuel in trouble. Little Dirty Hamster control the match right now. Going for the pin again in his debut. Ref took his sweet time getting down to the canvas. Another one count. Right back to working on the hold from behind. Another neck twist. Puts Money Manuel right back down. And Little Dirty Hamster is all over him. Getting up to the second rope, telling him to get to his feet. Oh, the axe chop misses, but Little Dirty's right there and throws Money Manuel into the corner. Up on the shoulders he goes into a converted fireman's carry and drops him back down. And Little Dirty Hamster looking to end it now. Again, going for the pin. Little Dirty Hamster, your winner in his debut. Can't wait for the hamster dance celebration. Little Dirty Hamster picks up his win in his debut, sends Money Manuel home, who will get another chance tonight. He is in the Hardcore Stalltar. And Money Manuel having none of that. Coming up after this one, big match for the women. Here we go. He's butthurt. Here we go. Peace Rebellion and Carney Val. Welcome the newcomers to BOCW. It's Hunter and Ash Elizabeth joining in for BOCW Women's Division Competition. Here we go. Place your bet starting right now. Carney Val picking up the bets early. Match number two, BOCW Friday Makeup Tips. Is you doing this, right? Not sure what you're asking, Rod Long Money. You want to know what's going on, type exclamation. Actually, press the button down below. It says BOCW, or you just do this. There's your information, right there. There, wherever it is. Did I do that right? I'm not sure what you're asking either, Peace Rebellion. You followed me again. I'm sure. I'm assuming a mobile unfollow happened. Oh, the bet thing? Yeah, you did. It's exclamation point bet, not I bet. So it's exclamation point bet, like one word, the number you pick. So it'd be U3, and then the mount. Got 7 seconds left. Here we go. Match number two, BOCW Fatal 4-Way Extreme Rules between four women in the women's division, three of them relatively new to BOCW. And here she comes, Hunter, making her way to the ring. Pretty much. She wanted to be a hunter from Left 4 Dead. Raw Long Money, start using English in a way that makes sense, please. Don't know what bet them and win as random words are. Hunter making her way down to the ring. I told you there were some freaks debuting tonight. Mm-hmm. start trying to get some praise from the crowd. Creepy, but can she fight? We're about to find out. Now, I think Money Mammal's got the longest intro now. Here comes the other newcomer to BOCW Women's Wrestling. Ash Elizabeth making her way down to the ring. Those of you unaware, Ash Elizabeth is my girlfriend. Very quiet. She's not going to talk in chat. I'll be managing her challenges for her, but got her into women's division. I need some pyro, man. Raw Long Money, again, beat them. What's that mean? Contribute to chat, please. There she is, Ash Elizabeth, in the ring. Here comes the next challenger. Made her debut during WrestleMania on Monday. Peace Rebellion making her proper BOCW debut. Thank you very much. Jamal, didn't see Peace Rebellion on Sunday? Match made you hungry. She is a highway star, man. It's a great song. That's the part I hope make Dustin really uncomfortable. Peace Rebellion.
Well, look at you.
Making her normal BOCW debut after her appearance at WrestleMania. And here she is. You all know her. Carney Val making her way to the ring right now to welcome all three of these ladies into BOCW properly. Dustin says stay sad. With some body slams! Yeah! Carney Val in the ring. Line him up. Warm him up, says Mads. Here we go. Fatal 4-Way Extreme Rules. Two newcomers in the ring. Hunter and Ash Elizabeth taking on Peace Rebellion. And the standard bearer for the women's division in this match, Carney Val. Let's go. Carney Val immediately goes outside the ring, and Ash goes looking for her as Hunter gets Peace Rebellion over the ropes. What's going on here? Look at this. Ash with Carney Val. Oh, into the barricade goes Carney Val. And Hunter with a mean drop of Peace Rebellion off the ropes. Ash in control early with Carney Val out by the announcer's table as Hunter kicks away at Peace Rebellion in the ring and follows it up with punches. Ash taking Carney Val back to her feet, gets countered. Knee to the face, drops Ash. And again, Hunter puts Peace Rebellion in the ropes. A chair to the head of Ash outside by the announcer's table. Carney Val had enough. Up to the second rope goes Hunter. And the zombie eyesight didn't work very well there as she went flying past Peace Rebellion. Carney Val throwing Ash into the ring post. Carney Val now getting back in control over the newcomer. Hunter gets countered by Peace Rebellion. Oh, and a big kick from the hippie. Drops the zombie down to the canvas. Carney Val still working on Ash outside the ring. Hunter now being whipped over the ropes, and Peace Rebellion tracks her down. Oh, and she gets countered off the ropes, as does Carney Val, as Ash gets back to a rhythm outside the ring, dropping Carney Val with a big kick. As Hunter and Peace Rebellion go back and forth inside the ring, Hunter with the counter reversal gets behind her and drops her down. Carney Val on her knees as Ash swings and tries to get a piece. It looks like Carney Val might have been glitched there, but Ash throws her into the ring post. Ash goes back inside as Hunter and Peace Rebellion go at each other. Look at the big jumping knee drop into the face of Carney Val from Ash. Hunter goes for the pin on Peace Rebellion early inside the ring. No one else sees it. Ash did, but no help necessary as Peace Rebellion kicks out of that. Carney Val down on her face outside the ring as the three newer women in BOCW in the ring fighting at each other. The uppercut counter from Peace Rebellion stuns Hunter as Ash goes back outside looking for another piece of Carney Val. Carney Val says, get back in the ring. Throwing her inside, Peace Rebellion celebrating as Hunter looks for her energy on the apron. Ash whips Carney Val right back outside the ring and follows her out. Now everyone's outside the ring. Carney Val reversing Ash and throwing her down. Peace Rebellion looking underneath the apron, and Carney Val now wants a piece of the zombie as the two Freakazoids go looking for each other. The bat is out. Peace Rebellion tried to swing it at Ash. Ash takes it away. Swings, misses. Peace Rebellion counters her as Hunter is in the clutches of Carney Val outside the ring as well. Look at that move from Peace Rebellion, throwing Ash down to the surface. Hunter slammed down by Carney Val. Look at the backflip off the barricade wall from Hunter, from Peace Rebellion. Carney Val there to break up the party. Oh no, she gets countered. Carney Val slammed down by Peace Rebellion, who's in control right now. Carney Val thrown back into the ring by Peace Rebellion. Ash wanted a piece and follows him in. Hunter playing to the fans outside and then goes back in the ring as well. Hunter and Ash find each other, the two newcomers, and Ash is brought down to the mat at the same time that Carney Val is dropped down by Peace Rebellion, and Ash goes outside for a nap. Now Peace Rebellion, the somersault up in the air she goes, slamming down into the midsection of Carney Val, but Hunter's right there to break that up, slamming Peace Rebellion down. Ash sitting up, Hunter now the only wrestler standing. Carney Val takes a kick to the face. Yeah, drop quality money, Manuel. Hunter in control right now. Peace Rebellion says, I don't think so. Counters the kick. Up to the rope she goes. Ash is there, crawling on top of the zombie. Carney Val crawling for the ropes. Ash with the headbutts to the face of Hunter. As Peace Rebellion stands by watching, Carney Val going over, looking for a piece of Peace Rebellion. She's up there. Waited a long time to jump off there. Look at this from Ash. She misses with the big backflip off the ropes. Ash going for the win in the pin. Carney Val focused on Peace Rebellion. And Hunter kicks out of that. Peace Rebellion jumps right back in the ring. Carney Val up on the top rope. Jumps and misses. As Hunter counters Ash, twisting the knee. Carney Val's down. Peace Rebellion going right back at Hunter, throwing her over the ropes. Ash still down. Carney Val counters and punches away at Peace Rebellion, who gets a piece in return and then goes back to kicking Ash on the canvas. Now Hunter going after Carney Val, twisting her around and dropping her down to the canvas. Peace Rebellion up, and look at the range. Looks like she caught Carney Val with that as Ash got out of the way. And now look at Ash grabbing the neck of Hunter and just throwing her down to the canvas. The pin attempt from Peace Rebellion, and Carney Val kicking out of that. Ash going for Peace Rebellion, dropping her down. And look at this reversal. The pin attempt again. And Peace Rebellion kicking out of that as Hunter's outside the ring. Carney Val sitting up. Peace Rebellion,
the time has come to bring the ruckus.
Throwing Ash off the ropes, jumping over on her way back. Another jump from Peace Rebellion. Look at these moves, and the big flying elbow from Peace Rebellion sends Ash outside the ring. And Peace Rebellion in control, but no, there's a counter from Carney Val. And she grabs her and drives her head first down into the mat. Hunter now back to her feet, trying to get back inside. Stop shooting at me. This match is nuts, yeah. Peace Rebellion trying to get to her feet. Carney Val and Hunter going underneath the apron. The sledgehammer comes out from Carney Val and she throws it right into the midsection of Peace Rebellion. Follows up with an elbow that missed as Peace Rebellion rolled underneath, and Hunter found the ladder and she puts that back in the ring as Ash finds her way back inside the ring as well. Hunter and Ash find each other. Ash flips Hunter over again as Carney Val continues to punch away at Peace Rebellion. Ash starts to celebrate. The big backflip, and there it is. Ash going down for the pin on Hunter as Carney Val and Peace Rebellion go outside. And Hunter kicks out of that at the last minute. As Ash delivers another blow to the zombie, backflipping again, knees after knees to the midsection of the zombie. Carney Val counters the kick for Peace Rebellion outside the ring. Over the top rope goes the zombie. Carney Val picks up Peace Rebellion inside the ring again. And the hippie reverses that one, driving the knee into the midsection of Carney Val. Ash takes down Hunter outside the ring on the Mixer logo. Carney Val and Hunter down. Peace Rebellion and Ash in control right now. Hunter turns Ash around, throws her back in the ring as another big flip slams in the midsection of Carney Val at the hands of Peace Rebellion. Hunter picking up Ash, punching away. Carney Val counters. Lifts Peace Rebellion over her shoulders and slams her and goes immediately for the pin on Ash. Hunter misses with the breakup. She's hung up and Ash kicks out of that one. Look at the big flying climbing move from Peace Rebellion. Carney Val celebrating over Ash and Peace Rebellion takes her down. Now Ash looking for Peace Rebellion, picks her up off the canvas. And Peace Rebellion gets to Ash first, kicking her in the face and dropping her down. Reverse kick to the face of Ash. Another one into the midsection. Ash is staggered as Peace Rebellion continues to work away. Carney Val down. Hunter getting back to her feet. Peace Rebellion throws Ash into the near corner. Ash grabs the leg, counters, drops the elbow on the knee. Oh, look at this from Ash. Taking Peace Rebellion down. Hunter going for the pin. Carney Val kicking out of that one as Ash didn't pay attention to it and continued to work on Peace Rebellion, powerbombing her down to the canvas. Hunter putting the submission hold on Carney Val. Another big drop of the knees, another big backflip of knees into the midsection of Peace Rebellion from Ash. As Hunter kicks away at Carney Val, Ash takes Peace Rebellion back to her feet. Carney Val driven down. Another counter in the corner from Ash. Peace Rebellion didn't see that one coming as Hunter goes to the pin. That was broken up from... Nope. Ash in the corner with the pin attempt, and there it is! Ash wins her debut, pinning Peace Rebellion in the corner. No one picked Ash to win that match, and she pulls it away. What a match.
Embrace the rage.
Two women debut, and that was a hell of a match for a debut. Ash celebrates her debut victory in BOCW. Long money, man. It's not hard. Contribute to chat, or the mods are going to tell you to have a nice night. You were given one warning. You can't seem to figure it out. Here we go. Match number three coming up. This one is for Intercontinental title seeding. It is an over-the-top rope battle royale for the mid-tier contenders in Intercontinental Championship. Place your bets starting right now. From left to right is Music 72, Sass, DJ Wu, Super Dude, Ulti, the Ultimate Redhead, and Lord Eye Fixer. Thank you very much, Dr. Death. There are your options as we line up match number three. That was a hell of a match to start off for Hunter and Ash in women's wrestling and BOCW. One minute left on your bet. No one's placed a bet yet. There we go. Or maybe my chat was lagged. One of the two happened. Rebellion placing the bet on Fixer. Yep, it's big, Dustin. It's bigger when you start putting your own assets in the game, too.
Come on, game and load now. Come on, game and load now.
Anytime now, game. We'll see. Six man over the top rope battle royale for intercontinental seeding coming up. And making his way to the ring first is DJ Wu. That window is closed, Dirk. 69, dude. Bets are evenly split. Two on DJ Wu, two on Ulti, and two on Fixer. Music picked up one, Sask picked up one, and no one bet on Super Dude. Not a whole lot of tribute, you stingy bastards. Too late now, Music. Bet window is closed. Here he comes, first challenger in this battle royale. It is the man no one chose, Super Dude, making his way to the ring. Super Dude representing Super Sweet Squirrel in the ring right now. Look at Woo Woo's focus face. Again, guys, thank you all for being here tonight. I know it's a Friday night. We tend to not have wrestling on the weekends until the weekend's over. You guys can enjoy it. But, again, thanks for dealing with the postponement yesterday due to work. It was not done until midnight. And thanks for being here tonight, supporting BSCW on an unorthodox night for us. Super Dude getting into the ring. Yeah, no space. Oh yeah, it's annoying. And now Sask. Sask, who's on a 1v1 rampage in BSCW, has not been faring well in multi-man matches, making their way down. I know, Dr. Death, but I still appreciate it, and I wouldn't be me if I didn't say thank you. I know that it was really late because I was like already in the middle of hyping up the show, and then all of a sudden, you know, shit happened. The good news is I was able to work on wrestlers because I was sitting here, and I was able to get everybody in. Elbows up! Sask the Dandy makes his way into the ring. The winner of this match will move up into the upper tier of the IC standings. IC belt will be the second belt contested in the new cycle. And there he is, the ultimate redhead. Looking to climb the intercontinental ranks, making his way to the ring. Ulti usually streams on Friday nights, which is why he's not here tonight. Oh man, that sucks. Tape it. I hope your toe's okay, man. Ulti gets in the ring. Ulti was your Hardcore Stalltar champion and your Mixer Chat champion And Kesselmania saw the end of all that for him. He walks back into BCW, a humbled man. Alti looking to regain some stature in BCW tonight. Here he is, Music 72, making his way to the ring. That sucks, Dr. Death. Music 72, three-time Hardcore All-Star champion, did not get into Hardcore tonight. Awesome, Mads. I'll have to check that out. Yeah, me and Alti have been on similar paths in terms of equipment building stuff and taking our time building up stuff. The Green Terror, Music 72 in the ring as these wrestlers get ready for this over-the-top rope battle royale. Collection. Here comes the heavyweight champion looking to move up the intercontinental ranks tonight. Lord Eye Fixer walking out with the heavyweight title. Trying to jump up into that top 10 ranking in IC. We'll see if he can do it tonight, or will he be humbled by one of these other five wrestlers? That belt not on the line in this match. Music and the rest of the crew stand by waiting. Yeah, here it comes. Lord Match Fixer would have won freaking Unified, okay? It's the second time I was first runner-up. Hell of a match, by the way. Blame Mixer. VOD for Castlemania did not save, thanks to all the problems they were having. Lord Eye Fixer making his way to the ring representing the Four Horsemen. Four Horsemen wrestling a few times tonight. Fixer in Hardcore, Stalltar, Savickly Madriel defending the Women's Mixer Chat Championship coming up later on tonight. Yes, that Pod Collection sound clip is from Rick and Morty Jamal, and it's in reference to Darkest Dungeon. We were watching Ulti play one night, and the Collector character based off the Yellow King in Cthulhu Mythos comes out, and Ulti says, "No, I don't want to see your Pog Collection." So we use that soundbite now. Fixer in the ring. Let's see who's going to win this over the top rope battle royale.
Always be yourself, unless you can be a unicorn.
I'd be a unicorn. I mean, if you didn't get them pick on me, I could be a unicorn. Here we go. Sass finds DJ Wu, Super Dude, and Music pair off, and the Ultimate Redhead and Lord Eye Fixer find themselves in the corner. Fixer trying to get Ulti up on the turnbuckle. Super Dude kicking back, countering away at Music, and DJ Wu trying to get Sask out. The big miss from Super Dude, and then another miss from Music. And now Super Dude put down by Music on the canvas. A lot going on in the middle of the ring. Ulti punching away at Fixer. Super Dude taking punishment from Music. And Sask has turned the tables on DJ Wu, punching him back. Fixer tried to counter with an elbow. Missed. Ulti comes right back, hammering away at the punches. Music punching on. Everyone's just punching right. A big kick there from Music. Drop Super Dude. Fixer in trouble with the hands of Ulti in the corner. DJ Wu reversing Sask as Music throws Super Dude down, and Ulti throws Lord Eye Fixer into the far corner, turning him around. Music again, the backbreaker delivered to Super Dude. Sask reversing DJ Wu and driving him back first into the canvas as Ulti tries to eliminate Fixer early. Yeah, it was a boxing match. Fixer with the counter, elbow to the face, the Ultimate Redhead drives him back. Music countered the hold from Sask, and Sask starts taking punishment from Fixer as they trade off, and Ulti goes after Music in the corner. Super Dude up on the shoulders of DJ Wu, spins him around and flips him into the near corner. Ulti punching away, missing, and now picking up Music as Fixer dropping Sass down to the canvas with some punches, misses with a kick, and Sass comes right back. Ulti continuing to just punch. Music back toward those ropes. Headbutt from Ulti. Super Dude punching DJ Wu. This is a boxing match. Everyone just keeps punching. Ulti down at the hands of Music. Sash dropped by Fixer. DJ Wu flipped, hits the top rope. as Super Dude finds Lord Eye Fixer and drops him down. Music kicks at ulti and misses, and now Super Dude goes looking for a piece of Music. Music and Super Dude back and forth in the middle of the ring. DJ Wu reverses ulti as he tried to pick him up. Sass down, Fixer down. Music clutching his back. Super Dude on his feet. DJ Wu finds ulti, taking him over to the corner. Trying to lift him out. Ulti has his hands on the top rope. Fixer still down right there as Sass drags him back in the ring. And there goes Music over the rope. And he holds on. It comes right back in. Super Dude couldn't get the elimination done. But there he is. Super Dude right back to work on Music, flipping him over. Sass trying to take Fixer to the ropes, getting countered. Low to the midsection. Super Dude up onto the middle rope, telling Music to get back to his feet as Fixer takes Sass to the ropes, to the corner. DJ Wu getting backed up by Ulti and now reverses Ulti, grabbing him. And this is a punch fest right now. Ulti elbows to DJ Wu as Fixer tries to kick Sask out. Sask went over the ropes. Fixer couldn't get the boot done as Sask counters. Going at the knee of Lord High Fixer. Ulti taken down by Super Dude. And now Super Dude picks up Fixer. Suplexes him down to the canvas. DJ Wu kicking away at Music 72. Dropping him down. Sask dropped by Ulti. Super Dude looks on as Fixer again hangs on at the apron, and Ulti says, "I don't think so." Kicks him while he's down. Super Dude with a big flying kick. DJ Wu sidesteps that, and DJ Wu down, as is Super Dude, the hands of Music, who then drops an elbow in the midsection of Sask. Music up to the top rope, drops the big elbow into the chest of Sask as Lord Eye Fixer eliminates Ulti on the far ropes. The Ultimate Redhead is eliminated. Fixer goes looking for Super Dude. Super Dude gets the best of that, flipping Lord Eye Fixer over, and Fixer goes at Sask as Music is still down. DJ Wu getting countered in the corner by Super Dude as Sask picks up Fixer and just drops him gutbuster on the leg. Money Man Will, yes, you did lose your first match. The roundhouse kick from Super Dude is caught by Fixer and countered. Fixer drops him with a big kick. Music still down. DJ Wu again. It is a punch fest as Sask continues to just deliver punches and elbows to DJ Wu, backing him up, and Super Dude counters Fixer, dropping him down, and Sass picking up DJ Wu near the ropes. Can this be the end of it for DJ Wu? It is. DJ Wu eliminated at the hands of Sass. We're down to four wrestlers. Sass punching away at Fixer. Fixer counters that and delivers a blow of his own, dropping Sass back to the corner. A big drop kick from Fixer. Drop Sass. Music taking punches from Super Dude and then counters. And drops Super Dude down to the canvas. Now Sass back to work on Fixer, and Fixer gets grabbed by Music from behind. Fixer taken over to the ropes as Sass celebrates. Super Dude's down, and Fixer counters Music from the ropes, but he's right back on the ropes as Music lines him up. And there goes Lord High Fixer, eliminated at the hands of Music 72, and there are three left in this Intercontinental match. Super Dude's rocked by Sass as Music starts to celebrate. Music, be careful. If Sass gets you one-on-one, it might spell trouble. As Sass drives Music down to the canvas, Super Dude's back to his feet. Sass goes right at him, slamming Super Dude down onto his leg, sweeping him backwards, and bring him down to the canvas. Super Dude taken to the ropes by Sass, who looks to line him up, and there it is. Music down with Super Dude eliminated by Sass. Sass going after Music, and this is where Sass lives. 1v1. But Music right to the counter, quickly driving Sask face first into the canvas. And now Music backs up, climbs up on the ropes, and begins to celebrate. Super Dude on the outside can't believe he was eliminated. Sask down in the ring, and Music decides to focus back on Sask. Elbow dropped into the midsection of Sask, and Music in control right now. Another elbow coming, and it's dropped. And now Music waits as Sask gets back to his feet. Music in control right now. The big super kick delivered from Music. Music still in control. No. Sask counters, driving Music back toward the ropes and into the midsection. Sask has Music right where he wants him. The big clothesline. And there's your winner, Sask, taking Music out of the ring. And Sask again gets a 1v1 opportunity at the end there and makes the most of it. Sask, your winner. Harney Val, the only person picking Sask. Match number 4 coming your way next. It is to decide who faces Lord High Fixer for the heavyweight title Sunday night's main event. Who gets a shot? You're about to find out. Sweet Dave, Dustin, and Lyndon SG fighting for a chance to take on Lord High Fixer. Heavyweight title match opportunity on the line. Here we go. I'm going to start the bet window for you guys. And then I am going to go to the bathroom. So here we go. Bet window open. Min 10, max 250. Sweet Dave, Odd Dustin, or Lyndon. Which one faces Fixer Sunday? We're going to find out right now. And I'll be right back. Go, let's get going with the heavyweight match. Sweet Dave, Odd Dustin, the heavy favorite. One of these three will take on Lord High Fixer Sunday night for the heavyweight title. Odd Dustin makes his way to the ring. Looking for a chance at redemption against Fixer, who eliminated him in short order the last time the heavyweight title was on the line. Betting closed, Dustin is the favorite. Sweet Dave has worked his way very, very hard up into this title opportunity. He is the two-time defending Phil's Big Wheel champion. He has consistently stayed in the top 10, and he gets his chance tonight. Finally into that top tier of rankings in heavyweight division. All hail the dirtiest man in BSCW. That's true, but here he comes. Here's Sweet Dave. Sweet Dave looking for his first ever major title opportunity. Your Phil's Big Wheel champion making his way to the ring. Hot dog belt not on the line in this match. Want that wiener? Well, you gotta spin in on Sunday. Sweet Dave defends that belt on Sunday. He gets his name etched on it. Sweet Dave, the Phil's Big Wheel hot dog belt champ. And here he is. You know him, you love him. Lyndon SG making his way down to the ring. It would also be Lyndon's first chance at heavyweight if he wins, or it could be a repeat of past events if Odd Dustin does. Either Sweet Dave or Lyndon get their first chance, or Odd Dustin gets right back in again. I think that's like the third time we have that quote. I want that wiener. Lyndon SG makes his way down to the ring. Lyndon does not like Dustin very much. Lyndon does not like Sweet Dave very much. No one likes Lyndon very much in BSW Universe. Dustin gets four tributes taken from him by the monster. Have a nice night, Rudy Coop, City Cop. Peace, dude. Oh no, you really hurt us! You're so edgy! Ah, Dustin, sweet Dave! With NSG facing off for a title opportunity. Here we go, triple threat, extreme rules. Nope, didn't last long at all. Dave looks for Dustin. Dustin has his eyes on Lyndon, and Lyndon catches sweet Dave. Lyndon dropping sweet Dave down, and that was that wasn't a suplex, just flipping Dustin over and slamming him down, and now here it is. The leg lock on the head of Odd Dustin. Lyndon hammering away with the elbows. Dustin is stunned. Sweet Dave back to his feet, trying to get behind Lyndon, and Lyndon sees it, but sweet Dave gets the elbow off. But Lyndon can't let sweet Dave finish the move, counters him, puts him down to the canvas, and Lyndon in control, kicking away at sweet Dave. Dustin was stunned, grabbed Lyndon, and Lyndon immediately countered Dustin, and Lyndon in control of this match early. Was it Fixer? That's always me. I'm always a good troll. Lyndon whipping Dustin off the ropes on his way back, puts the feet into the chest, and Dustin's hurt. Lyndon went outside real quick, still focused on Dustin, and sweet Dave takes advantage, throwing Lyndon off the ropes. And sweet Dave delivers the elbow to the face of the luchador as Lyndon took his first damage and immediately went outside the ring. That one must have hurt. Now Dustin brought back up by sweet Dave. Sweet Dave goes to the move and gets countered. Odd Dustin punching the face of the Phil's Big Wheel champion. And sweet Dave, all of him slammed down by Dustin in the far corner. As Lyndon gets back to his feet, gets back inside the ring, breaks up the dirty, dirty hold from Odd Dustin, saving sweet Dave the pain. Dave brought back to his feet. Dustin went for Dave. Kind of hit both of them and it all got broken up. Now sweet Dave has Lyndon with the elbow breaker, and Dave stays focused on Lyndon as Dustin backs off and takes a break in the corner. Says, when's my turn, damn it, I want that wiener. Dustin went over at Lyndon while sweet Dave had him in a hold, put Lyndon down to the canvas, and immediately got Dave slammed down. Now Dustin standing tall in the ring with Lyndon down and Dave going for the nap outside by the Mixer logo. Dustin drops the knee into the back of Lyndon. Dustin kicks, misses. Lyndon to his feet, gets behind Dustin, suplexes him down, and Lyndon back in control. Lyndon bringing Dustin back up, and Dustin reverses him. Sweet Dave was behind Dustin, who didn't see him. The twist, no, the push away from Odd Dustin. Now Dustin putting Sweet Dave up. Lyndon Dave's on the top rope. Sweet Dave slammed down by Dustin in the corner. And the head of the Mosh Potatoes in control, punching away at Sweet Dave's face. Sweet Dave still down. Lyndon back in action, waits as Dustin continues to punch away at the face of the Phil's Big Wheel champion. Dustin caught Lyndon looking, grabs him, takes him over to the top rope, throws him off of it, and Lyndon's down. Sweet Dave still down in the far corner, and Dustin in control, looking for another shot at Lord Eye Fixer if he wins this match. Dustin went for Sweet Dave and got countered on the way up. Sweet Dave, the big European uppercut, drops on Dustin, and Sweet Dave rolls his way outside the ring, looking underneath the apron as Dustin goes for a nap, and Lyndon's back to his feet, going after Sweet Dave, who comes out from underneath the ring with a baseball bat. Lyndon in the ring. Sweet Dave swings, but no, Lyndon grabs it, and now Lyndon has the bat and drops Sweet Dave in the corner with the broadside of that bat and throws it outside the ring. Dustin sitting up, Sweet Dave being brought back to his feet by Lyndon. Lyndon, no, the whip reversal. Sweet Dave runs after him, and that gets broken up. And now Sweet Dave throwing Lyndon into the far corner, but Dustin was there to meet him, breaking Dave's back and putting him down to the canvas as Lyndon rests, and Dustin goes for the pin as Lyndon looks on. Dustin tries to go for the win, and Sweet Dave kicks out of that one. Nope. Sweet Dave still down. Dustin with the big punch into the side, and now the claw from Odd Dustin, and Lyndon breaks that up. Dustin really wanted to do the claw again. Instead, kicks the back after Lyndon breaks it up a second time. Now Lyndon whipping on Dustin into the near corner. He punched Dave's ear. Dustin countered Lyndon, and now Lyndon comes back with a counter of his own, punching away at Odd Dustin, locking the legs around his neck, and there's Dustin down like a dead man in the ring, and Lyndon in control. Sweet Dave, low crawling, looking for a way back to his feet. Lyndon goes for the kick. Dustin says, I don't think so. Sweeps out the other leg and drops Lyndon down. There's Dustin rolling Lyndon over in a submission hold, and Sweet Dave breaks that one up. Lyndon goes outside for another break. Sweet Dave and Dustin grabbing for each other. Dave wasn't happy about it, started to pout, and Dustin rolls him over for the pin. No one there to break this one up. Sweet Dave kicking out of that one. What an interesting pin that was from Dustin. I don't think I've seen you try that one before. Oh no, here it comes. The choke slam from Dustin. Up goes Dave and down he goes. And Dave is stunned but finds the ropes quickly and right back to his feet. And oh my goodness, what a counter from Dave right after he got chokeslammed. The European uppercut drops Dustin. Dave goes for the pin as Linden gets back in the ring and breaks that one up. Now Linden continues to punch away at Dustin while he's down as Dave backs off. Now Linden putting the submission hold on Dustin, rolling him over. Sweet Dave didn't see it. Sweet Dave was too busy celebrating and didn't see Linden putting on the submission hold, and Linden gets the win. And Linden will face Lord Eye Fixer for the heavyweight title. What a doofus move from Sweet Dave. Too busy having a good time on the ropes as Linden pulls off the submission on Dustin. Little bit, Dave. Linden, your winner. Take your tributes. 7 Queen Madriel, Money Man Will. Yep. Linden gets a title shot on Sunday. We'll see if he holds on to it. Linden SG, your winner, as we move into the last three matches and the first title that's on the line. Linden celebrates. And the crowd boos. No one happy Linden won that one. But Linden, for the first time ever, will get a chance at the BOCW heavyweight title on Sunday night. It's called Rings of Saturn, and it's not nice. Linden, your winner, as we move towards Mixer Chat Championship in the men's division. Skinja Ninja looking to defend the title for the first time since winning it at Kesselmania. Here we go.
Welcome to this.
Mir Raindrop 550, thanks for the follow. Welcome to BOCW Friday Night Makeup Tips, because we're making up Thursday night stream. Here we go, max 250 or max 500, because this is a title match and we don't have a signature belt on the line tonight. So place your bets starting now from left to right. Dr. Death, the Colonel, Penn's Booth Anger, OG Killer Squirrel, and the defending Mixer Chat champions, Ginja Ninja. Here we go, place your bets starting right now. Mixer Chat champion, apparently, because I can't type. Seconds left in your bet window. Option one is Matt. Option two, Squirrel. Option three, Dr. Death. And option four is the champion, Skinja Ninja, looking to hold on to that Mixer Chat championship. Will he do it? We're going to find out right now. Seconds left in your bet window. As Matt Pensboo's Anger makes his way to the ring for this cage, your Unified Champion and one half of the Tag Team Champion, Alcoholigans, who defended their Tag Team title at Kesselmania. Betting is closed. Squirrel and Dr. Death, the favorites. No one betting on the Colonel. Skinja Ninja, the defending Mixer Chat Champion, picking up two bets. The greatest man in BOCW? Man, let's not say crazy shit like that now, huh? Oh my god, he's got a cult of personality. J. Jamal and Sweet Dave. Stop it. Oh, greasiest. Okay. Thank God. Yeah, definitely the greasiest man. The Colonel in the ring, I will refer to him as Matt during play-by-play. For those of you new to BSCW. And here he comes. OG Killer Squirrel, your current hardcore Stalltar champion, looking to put another belt on his hips before he defends tonight in our main event. Yeah, I love this intro too. This intro is an advanced intro. I spent a fair amount of time on it. Several of the intros are advanced intros. Hunter's is an advanced intro. Ash's is an advanced intro. A couple other ones. OG Killer Squirrel making his way down to the ring. Your hardcore Stalltar champion looking to take Mixer Chat champion away from Skinja Ninja. Can he do it? That is the first piece of hardware Squirrel ever owned. He rolled into Kesselmania and took it home and found himself in the unified match. More time, everybody. Thanks for being here. I know I say it a lot. It doesn't mean a lot to me. You guys interrupting what is not a normal night to be here and watch BOCW. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Squirrel into the ring. Two belt squirrel, let's go. I got no problem with that.
Anger is power. Unleash it.
Reminder, after this match, we have another Mixer Chat Championship match, this time on the women's side. Queen Death, Ash, and Savage Queen Madriel, the defending champion, coming up next. But first, the People's Panda making his way to the ring. Dr. Death looking to put his hands back on some hardware. Broken toe and all, won't stop the Panda Bear. He's powered up on bamboo and ready to slam fools.
Skadoosh,
but first, yep. Dr. Death into the ring. Bubble 3, hey, how's it going? Welcome to BSCW on an abnormal night for us on Friday night. The People's Panda in the ring, waiting for the cage to drop, waiting for his chance at Mixer Chat Championship. And here comes the defending Mixer Chat Champion on his way to the ring. Another cartoon showdown is about to happen. The Skinja Ninja, your defending Mixer Chat Champion, making his way down the ramp with the championship belt. Can he defend it? Or will he lose it right after earning it at Kesselmania? That belt on the line. Which one of these four goes home with it as the cage drops down on them? The cage match can have a pin or a climb out. I am going to create a custom match very shortly for cage matches. That means you can only win by climbing out. Yes, that is Pickle Rick. It's Skinja Ninja, though. There we go, that belt on the line, the Mixer Chat Championship for the men's division. The cage is lowered as the Colonel, Matt, OG Killer Squirrel, your hardcore Stalltar champion, the People's Panda, Dr. Death, and the defending Mixer Chat champion, Skinja Ninja, get set to go. The Colonel finds Dr. Death, Squirrel in the clutches of the Pickle. The Colonel slammed down by Dr. Death as Skinja Ninja rolls over, twisting the knee of Squirrel. Dr. Death drops the knee into the back of the head of Matt as Ginja Ninja breaks the guts of Squirrel. Dr. Death up on the top rope, waiting for Matt to get up. Squirrel on his knees. Skinja has him. The big jumping slam from the Panda Bear sends the King of Kentucky Fried Chicken down to the mat, and Squirrel reverses, putting Skinja down to the canvas. Dr. Death in business on Matt right now. Squirrel, arm over the neck, trying to lift Skinja Ninja up, and counters it with a punch to the midsection. Dr. Death kicking away at the Colonel. Matt still down. Squirrel countering Skinja Ninja, sending him back toward the ropes. Matt lifting Dr. Death up and just tossing him down like a teddy bear. As Squirrel continues to punish away. No, the counter. Elbows to the face of Squirrel to hands of Ginja Ninja, the defending champion. Matt with a big suplex on Dr. Death. Ginja Ninja driving Squirrel down into the canvas. And this is anyone's match now. Nope. You guys are oil brothers. Dr. Death with the reversal. Sending Matt down to the canvas. Ginja Ninja in control now with Squirrel. It's like two different dances going on. Skinja on the ropes waiting for Squirrel to get up as Dr. Death drops another knee into the back of Matt. Look at this. Squirrel catches Skinja Ninja off the ropes and drops him face first off the turnbuckle as Panda Bear continues to punish away at Matt. Now Squirrel puts the foot into Skinja Ninja, who grabs it and throws it out from underneath Squirrel, sending him down to the canvas. Matt down, clutching his face. Dr. Death starts to climb. His cartoon counterpart sees it, grabs his leg and says, "Get over here," and brings it back down the ring as the partners exchange, and now it's a cartoon cavalcade on the left side, and Matt and Squirrel pair off. Matt counter punching away at Squirrel, now the kick as Skinja puts Dr. Death in a fireman's carry and sends him down to the canvas. Squirrel getting wrecked at the hands of Matt right now. Dr. Death quickly gets behind Skinja Ninja, putting his foot into the back of that robo knee. Matt taunting Squirrel, saying, "Get up." As Skinja's dropped again by Dr. Death, and Matt dies face first off the turnbuckle right into Squirrel, dropping him, and Matt looks to the cage wall. Dr. Death sees him immediately and says, "Where are you going?" There's finger looking good action right here in the ring. Skinja in the corner. Squirrel doesn't go after him and instead swings at Dr. Death, now focuses on Matt again. Dr. Death turns around, sees Skinja coming for him, and throws Skinja into the corner. Matt out of the corner at the hands of Squirrel and face first driven into the canvas, and now Skinja working Dr. Death near the far ropes. Squirrel has Matt in a chokehold, bending his back backwards. As Skinja hammers away, leg lock, elbows into the head of the Panda Bear. Matt with a counter, now going after Squirrel near the near corner, taking him over to the near ropes. Skinja grabbing Dr. Death. Player 911 and a bunch of numbers, thanks for the follow and welcome to BCW. The pin attempt from Skinja. Matt wasn't aiming for that, but did break it up with that missed jump off the rope. Squirrel was a zip code away. Skinja drops the leg into the face of Dr. Death as Matt looks waiting. The cartoons again continue to pair off. Dr. Death slammed again by the defending champion, Skinja Ninja. Matt lifting up Squirrel by his neck and slamming him down. Matt in control of Squirrel. Skinja continues to work away on the People's Panda. Dr. Death rolled into Matt. Matt sidestepped it, still has Squirrel up, and drops him down. Dr. Death on the ropes was getting lined up by Skinja, and Matt delivers a super kick, and now Matt goes for the pin on Skinja. What's up, player? Skinja kicks out of that. Dr. Death just out of it on the ropes. Squirrel back to his feet and to his senses. Skinja taking kicks from the Colonel. Squirrel sees his opportunity and starts the climb. Dr. Death snaps out of it. Goes after Squirrel on the cage wall and throws him back in as Skinja continues to get worked by Colonel. Now Dr. Death eyeballing that cage wall. Skinja sees it and won't let Dr. Death go. Brings him back down inside. And now Skinja sees the cage and he's going to climb. No one sees Skinja going for the wall yet. Matt's down. The pin attempt from Squirrel. Can Squirrel stop Skinja Ninja? He's about to get out. Skinja going to hold on to the title. He's over the top. And Skinja Ninja successfully gets out of the ring, and he is going to be your Mixer Chat champion one more time. Skinja Ninja, the defending Mixer Chat championship, walks away with his belt. Done, sir. Coming up next, the first time in a regular show we have tribute buy-in to Women's Mixer Chat Championship. Don't forget, women of BOCW, it is dollar sign challenge in the BOCW channel prior to 6 p.m. Eastern time every Thursday to get into the match we're going to have next. Yeah, they can't get up there fast enough, so it's like, yeah, we can't get him. Basically, if you can get to the top of the cage, you're going to win it, unless someone's up there with you. It's Genja Ninja, still your Mixer Chat champion. Successfully getting out of the cage. Here we go, next match. Another big one for the women. Mixer Chat Championship on the line one more time. As Queen Dead, Ash Elizabeth, take on the reigning Mixer Chat Champion, Savage Queen Madriel. Another 500 bet opportunity here for you guys. Min 10, max 500 tributes. Here we go, 1 minute, 30 seconds. Place your bets starting right now. Mads did what the Mixer Chat Champion's supposed to do, and let me know what kind of match you wanted. This is a table, ladders, and chairs match. If you are the defending Mixer Chat Champion on either side, you can tell me what kind of match you want to defend in. It's in the rules, if you read them. Bets coming in. Mads, the Queen Death, picking up the best. Queen Death has a lot of tributes riding on her right now. One bet placed on Ash Elizabeth, the newcomer to BOCW. Debuted earlier tonight and won. Now in a position to take home a title on her first night. Every Thursday show, this will be the thing. If we have challenges on both sides, there will be two Mixer Chat Championship matches every Thursday.
Welcome to the pizza party.
YOLO 424242. Thank you for the follow. Welcome into BOCW. Friday night makeup tips, making up for Thursday night's broadcast. Mads betting on Ash. That belt hangs over the ring. As Ash Elizabeth makes her way back in for the second time tonight, looking to put her hands on the hardware. Betting is closed. It's fairly close. Two on Ash, two on Queen Death, and three on Mads. But most of the money on Queen Death. As Ash makes her way back down to the ring again. All right, Hunter, the way it works, dollar sign challenge in BOCW chat costs you 1,000 tributes to challenge for this belt. The belt would complete her outfit. We'll see. It's possible. Three-man ladder match doesn't usually last that long. Someone can get two people down and climb a ladder that's set up. It's usually over. Well, earn it. The thing is, Ash has a truckload of tributes. She's been here since my very first stream, quietly lurking in the background. She's got a ton. Ash in the ring, waiting to face her challengers. Here's the first one, Queen Death, making her way in. Money Manuel failed to steal from Streamjar, who seems to be the favorite target of the bot tonight. Queen Death looking for hardware for the first time in BOCW, and here's a legitimate opportunity for it. Mads also can't get a piece of the stream jar. Dirty Little Hamster loses four tributes to Carney Val. Card game starts. Mads starts a 50 tribute card game in the tavern as we go through the intros, waiting for Mixer Chat Championship to kick off again. Strong Dr. Death. Oh. We did. In the ring. Looking for that belt tonight. Maybe. And here she is, your defending Mixer Chat champion and women's queen of the ring champion, Savage Queen Madriel, making her way down. No belt on her waist because the belt she owns is hanging above the ring right now. Mads looking to defend for the first time Mixer Chat Championship after winning it at WrestleMania Sunday. Two smaller, faster wrestlers in the ring with Mads. Let's see what happens. Queen Death in the chat, hello. Mads warms up as the Mountain, the undisputable force in women's wrestling in BOCW. Savage Queen Madriel walks the ring, looking at her belt hanging high above it. Which one of these three walks away from it? We're about to find out. That's the belt on the line.
Good luck, and don't fuck it up.
Ash warming up in the corner, the newcomer, Queen Death, looking to get revenge on Mads, and Mads looking to continue to her streak going, and Mads goes right after Queen Death and puts her down to the canvas. Ash goes outside immediately after the ladder as Mads gets underneath the apron, going for a table, and there's a table and a ladder on its way into the ring. Ash swings and misses at Mads, catches her with a second blow. Mads didn't see her. Look at Ash taking down the champ and punching away at the face of Savage Queen Madriel as Queen Death sets the ladder up. Mads is stunned. Ash is going after that table now, throws it down. Queen Death telling Mads to get up. Ash trying to get Queen Death down off the ropes. Look at this. Ash throwing Queen Death down into the ladder. Mads is stunned. Ash whips Mads off the far ropes, dropping her back with a kick. But the champion counters a newcomer and drops her down with a big punch. And now Mads in control, whipping Queen Death over the ropes and back inside the ring. Mads in control, the table set up. And Mads drops it in the face of Ash and now pummels the leg of Queen Death with it as Ash goes outside for a nap. Mads starts to set the table up. A viable option. Mads, oh, we haven't seen her do this in a long time. She takes the cover off the turnbuckle and goes after Queen Death in the ring, dropping the elbow into her back as Ash comes to her senses outside. Mads starts to climb the turnbuckles. Queen Death still down, clutching her back. Mads goes up, oh my goodness, and drops the elbow into the back of Queen Death, who rolls away as Ash gets back in the ring. Queen Death gets the best of Mads, taking her over toward the table. Mads having none of that. And Ash comes in with the ladder and breaks up the action of both of those, dropping the champ, dropping Queen Death. Ash trying to track down Queen Death with the ladder. Mads misses, and now there's a struggle for the ladder. Mads takes away from Ash and hits her with it. Drops it down, and now Mads has Ash, throwing her over the top rope, punching her and dropping outside as another ladder comes out at the hands of Queen Death. Mads grabs the ladder inside the ring. Mads setting the ladder up. No one in the ring, outside the ring, sees her going for it. Mad unchallenged, going upstairs looking for that belt. And there's Queen Death. She sees it. She starts to climb the ladder to challenge the champion, dropping her face first off the ladder. Another faceplant off the ladder. And Queen Death says, get out of here. And Queen Death at the top of the ladder, unchallenged, trying to unlock it. As Mads rolls outside, Ash is getting to her feet. Will anyone stop Queen Death? Mads looks on, not running, taking her time. Queen Death still working the lock. Ash sees it. She's running. Mads is back inside the ring. She's trying to get up on top of the ladder. And Ash gets the punch in on Queen Death and breaks up the attempt. Queen Death taking punches from the newcomer. Now Mads on top of the ladder punching away. And Queen Death is in trouble. And she's dropped. And Ash climbs the ladder to challenge Mads. And there's Ash dropping Mads' face off the top of the ladder. No, Mads with a counterpunch. Throwing Ash down. And there's Mads on top of the ladder again, going for the belt. Ash is stunned. Queen Death is down. Like I said, these are usually over quick with only three people. The defending champion high on top of the ladder trying to unlock it. Will Maz get it unlocked before someone wakes up? Ash is waking up, but not in time as Savage Queen Madriel takes her belt from the clutches of the chain and takes it home one more time. Still, two belt Mads. Takes home Mixer Chat Championship for one more week. Pretty much, Dr. Death. But that's how it happens. One more match to go, everybody. I thought she had it too, Money Manuel. There was no one there, and she had all day. But Savage Queen Madriel, your winner. Take home your tributes winners. Broke your nose. Here it is, Hardcore Stalltar Championship. Our main event, the defending champion, OG Killer Squirrel, taking on Sweet Dave, Fortnite Fixer, Odd Dustin, the People Panda, Dr. Death, and newcomer Money Manuel. Let's get that one fired up. Another 500 tribute max bet. 90 seconds on the clock starting right now. The last match of Friday Night Makeup Tips here with BOCW. Yep. It won't be that easy if there's six people in there. Can OG Killer Squirrel defend his title? Or will Sweet Dave reclaim it? Fixer's been hardcore champ before. Dustin's been hardcore champ before.
You will endure this loss and learn from it.
Money Manuel, first night in BOCW, looking for a title. So the favorite is Dustin. One bet on Fixer, two on Money Manuel, one on Dave, no one taking Squirrel or Dr. Death. It's a bold strategy, Cotton. We'll see if it pays off. I know Dr. Death intentionally is not betting anymore. Come on, game and load now. Come on, game and load. Bet on Dusty? Oh, sweet. Betting closed. The odd Dustin, your favorite. We head into the last match of our makeup show. Carnival wasting no time. She has already challenged for Mixer Chat Champion next Thursday. Odd Dustin making his way to the ring. Odd Dustin losing a chance to take on Lord Eye Fixer earlier tonight for Heavyweight Championship on Sunday. Looking to get his hands on some hardware here. This is a ladder match only. Six competitors in the ring. Should be a little bit more crazy. Queen Death, I also said that you can take out of, if there's a husband-wife combo or significant other combo out there, I'm cool with the idea of basically having a shared tribute pool. When you challenge, you just need to know which pool it comes, like which person's amount it comes out of. I know that basically one TV sometimes or one computer makes it hard for two people to earn tributes. Dr. Death on his way to the ring to face off against his tag team partner, Odd Dustin. The Mosh Potatoes represented well in Hardcore Stalltar tonight. Pandemonium in effect. Dr. Death looking to get his hands on a belt. Yeah, that's probably partially the blame on Mixer problems on Sunday. I did update the rules right as Castlevania fired off so that they were there. But it's basically the same rules the men follow. Queen Death from her tribute pool challenges for Mixer Chat Championship next Thursday. Already two in there. It's awesome. We're going to start having crazy 4 and 6 women matches every Thursday night. Dr. Death in the ring. Who comes out next? How do you challenge? You have to have 1,000 tributes, Peace Rebellion, and then you just go to the BOCW channel on Discord and type $challenge. Lord Eye Fixer making his way to the ring. Your heavyweight champion looking to become a hardcore Stalltar champion once again. The women wasting no time. Usually the men, you have to like ask them, hey, are you guys sure you don't want to challenge? The women on top of it. Now Dr. Death puts in his challenge for Mixer Chat Championship next Thursday, so we will have both belts on the line again next Thursday. Yes, Peace Rebellion, you can do it anytime up to 6 p.m. Eastern Time Thursday night. That's when I lock it in, because that's when I'm basically in the build portion of making the card. But anytime up to 6 p.m. Thursday night. So if you don't have the tributes right now, you think you'll earn them Sunday night, you can tribute after the show Sunday. Or you can challenge after the show on Sunday. Anytime. Show does not have to be live. Lord Eye Fixer in the ring. Miss Ducky Hugs, welcome to BOCW. None of us watch WWE, really. Like, I know who Becky Lynch and Nia Jax are just from seeing their stuff in this game. Here he is, your defending hardcore Stalltar champion, making his way to the ring in his first defense of that title. Two creepy intros tonight in this championship match. Here's the first one, your champ. OG Killer Squirrel making his way to the ring. Thank you very much. A lot of work has gone into it. A lot of creative input from a lot of the people in the chat. Thank you for the follow. Thank you for the host. There he is, OG Killer Squirrel, making his way down in the ring. No belt on his waist because it's hanging high above the ring, as one of these six wrestlers will climb a ladder and try to take it down and home tonight. But Miss Ducky Hugs, if you are 18 years old, accumulate 5 hours in the channel and contribute in our Discord. We are still looking for women in BOCW. Just missed the Mixer Chat Championship, contested by 3 of them. And we had a fatal 4-way earlier tonight in the women's division. There we go. Thank you, Sweet Dave. Squirrel in the ring, looking to take his belt back home with him. Will it happen? Or will one of these other 5 wrestlers end the dream and become the new hardcore champion tonight? How many wrestlers do we have? There are 7 active women in BOCW. We need more. But 7 is good enough to have 2 titles that they compete for. Here he is, your Phil's Big Wheel Champion, Sweet Dave, making his way back to the ring. Dave will defend that Phil's Big Wheel belt Sunday night. If he is a winner, he will engrave his name on it. Hi, Ducky Hugs, hubby. Sweet Dave climbing in the ring. Has successfully held that Phil's Big Wheel belt for almost a month now. Blessing Wolf loses 20 tributes to the monster. I don't know. I mean, who's going to be your partner is the question. There's a random script that runs. Wesley Wolf selects a viewer every couple minutes and says, I want to take some tributes from him. That's the monster. Here he is, without a doubt now, with the longest intro in BSCW. We may have to do something about that. His second appearance on his debut night, going for Hardcore Star Talk Championship. It is Money Man Will. Can the newcomer walk away with the title tonight? You can get a drink and use a restroom during your intro. That's good to know. Yes. Well, it's kind of like Poe from Kung Fu Panda. Dr. Death is the People's Panda of BOCW. BOCW stands for Big Top Outlaws Championship Wrestling. Big Top Outlaws being the name of the community that I've kind of been in and held together as a group of gamers for, Christ, what's it now, 12 years? Really a loose confederation of people just like playing games together. And we are growing thanks to BOCW. Money Manuel coming down the ramp. Doing his voodoo dance. Sweet Dave stands in the ring saying, what the hell is going on? Ah, Dustin saying, get in there already, Chief. Fixer Squirrel looking on as the crowd reacts to the newcomer Money Manuel. Hug the cute panda. Be careful, he might hug you in the corner and rub all of his nasty man parts on you like happened at Kesselmania. I'm really sad that that's gone. That was hilarious.
What? No, I don't want to see your POG collection.
I'm going to have a look, Money Man, we'll see if any of the other intros that fit the music are shorter, just because. That's like a 2-minute intro. I mean, it's a sweet intro. It's a 2-minute intro. I'll let you know. I'll have a look after the show. I'll probably be tomorrow. But here we go. Finally, Hardcore Staltar on the line. Fixer not Dustin find each other. Sweet Dave taking kicks from the Panda Bear as Dustin immediately thrown out of the ring by Fixer, and the defending champion goes right after the newcomer. Money Manuel takes the blow to the face from Squirrel as Sweet Dave drops the Panda Bear down. Odd Dustin almost speared into the apron wall there. Fixer continues to kick away, trying to track down the leader of the Mosh Potatoes. Money Manuel suplexed by OG Killer Squirrel as Dr. Death flips Sweet Dave over. And look at this. Leg lock fiesta in the ring. Elbows to the head of Money Manuel and Sweet Dave. As the Panda Bear and OG Killer Squirrel had the same idea at the same time. Dr. Death up to the top rope. Money Manuel getting the best of Squirrel there, reversing that and driving him headfirst in the canvas. And Fixer still working on Dustin outside, taking him right up to the edge of the apron. Money Manuel punching away at the champ, grabbing him. Sweet Dave counters Dr. Death in the near corner. Fixer still punching away at Dustin as Squirrel elbows and then breaks Money Manuel's face. Dr. Death and Sweet Dave go outside the ring. Dustin still being slammed by Fixer. And another leg lock from Squirrel on Money Manuel in the ring. Sweet Dave thrown into the side of the apron by Dr. Death. Fixer throws Dustin into the barricade wall and then gets countered. Money Manuel drops the champ face first down to the canvas again. Money Manuel in control of it inside the ring right now as Odd Dustin finally getting some momentum back against Fixer. Dr. Death finds his way back in the ring. Sweet Dave down. Fixer counters Dustin. Money Manuel getting picked up by Squirrel. run off the top rope as Dustin is slammed down again by Fixer, and Sweet Dave being picked up by the Panda Bear and dropped down to the surface, squirreled to the second rope, telling the newcomer, Money Man, will get up to your feet. Fixer goes over, finds the Panda Bear, throws him into the wall, and Fixer taking on both mashed potatoes right now, picking up and powerbombing on Dustin down. Squirrel and Money Man will continue to dance in the ring. The spinning punch from Money Man will drop Squirrel. Dr. Death went for Sweet Dave and missed. The ladder's at their feet out there. Sweet Dave picking up the Panda Bear, taking over to the barricade wall and slamming into it. Oh, Dustin in a lot of pain as Fixer continues to punish away, but no. Dustin counters Fixer, putting him down. Sweet Dave rounds the corner, looking for Fixer before Dustin can get there. Quit shooting at me. Money Man will now getting worked on by the champ in the ring. No one interested in the ladder right now. As Money Man will thrown into the corner, a big clothesline delivered by Squirrel. Fixer back to his feet. Oh, Dustin has Sweet Dave picked up, slamming him down. Fixer looking for the Panda Bear and finds him, grabbing him. The champ has the ladder and it's in the ring. As most of the action continues along the bottom of the apron, Fixer slamming down Dr. Death. Squirrel starts to set the ladder up. Money Man will trying to get to his feet. And OG Killer Squirrel makes the climb, trying to get his belt back. Money Man Will sees it. He climbs up right after him and gut punches Squirrel as Sweet Dave puts Odd Dustin up in the fireman's carry and just throws him into the ring post. And there's a newcomer, Money Man Will, at the top of the ladder going for the title. No one sees it. Now Dr. Death does, and so does Sweet Dave, and they start to challenge him. Yes, we have an 84 rating limit in the league. Dr. Death trying to take on Money Man Will, who does not want to come off that ladder. And he gets punched off the top by the newcomer. Money Man Will goes for the belt instead of waiting for Squirrel, who throws him off the top of the ladder. Fixer down at the hands of Dustin, who gets back in the ring. Dr. Death and Money Man Will down as Dustin tries to kick over that ladder. It looks like Sweet Dave's going to help him as Squirrel goes to the lock. Squirrel hangs on for dear life. The ladder thrown in the corner. Squirrel falls down into Fixer's hands and is bombed down. Dustin now throws the person who just helped him outside the ring. And now Fixer's in the ring with Squirrel. Four wrestlers out by the announcer's table as Fixer starts to set the ladder up. Yeah, it makes it fair. We use Universe to give people bonuses, but that's it. Fixer at the top of the ladder, going for the lock. Squirrel's there. Dustin sees it. Now Dustin climbs the back. No, he just punches away at his nemesis from the bottom of the ladder. Squirrel at the top, punching away at Fixer. Oh, Dustin trying to get a piece of Lord Eye. Fixer grabs his boot. And there it is. Fixer down. Squirrel the champ back at the top of the ladder. As the People's Panda tried to get the ladder down and his tag team partner stunned him, and Squirrel continues to work on the lock. Dustin now climbs the ladder going after Squirrel as Fixer and the People's Panda work together to take that ladder out. And there they go. The ladder flies way outside the ring. Squirrel down. Dustin down. And now Odd Dustin sees his tag team partner, Dr. Death, take Lord Eye Fixer over to the corner. We know what time this is. As Sweet Dave says, I found me a ladder. It gets back in the ring. Odd Dustin flipping Squirrel over. This Skadoosh butt slam from Dr. Death into the midsection of Lord Eye Fixer, and he rolls away. Dr. Death lining up Squirrel, as is Odd Dustin. Who's going to get the piece? Man, Squirrel got it from both ends right there. Dr. Death from the front as they put Squirrel into the Chinese finger cuffs. The People's Panda sets the ladder up. No one sees it. Oh, Dustin taking his time lining up the choke slam as the People's Panda's at the top of the ladder trying to unlock it. No one paying any attention to Dr. Death, who wants that title. His partner sees it finally. Dustin breaks it up. Dustin lets his partner go as Dr. Death continues to work away on it. Oh, Dustin lets Dr. Death continue to work the lock as Sweet Dave sees it. Sweet Dave gets up the ladder, trying to break up Dr. Death's opportunities. Everybody's back in now. Dustin jumps and goes after Squirrel, but misses. And now Dr. Death throws Sweet Dave off the top of the ladder. Fixer going for Dr. Death, and he's kicked off by the People's Panda. And Dr. Death says, this is mine. Nobody able to get Dr. Death off the ladder. Finally, Squirrel punches him and stuns him. Fixer climbing. And there they go. Dustin and OG Killer Squirrel knocking everyone off the ladder as the ladder goes flying outside the ring. Dustin sent outside the ring by Squirrel. Money Man Will following them out there. Sweet Dave also looking to what's going on at the top of the apron as Fixer tries to get back to his feet. Yes, it does. Fixer back up. Money Man Will slamming down Sweet Dave. Odd Dustin about to get punished by Squirrel. Oh, right into the thigh. Now Fixer's outside the ring looking for the newcomer, punching away and missing wildly. He's too far away. Ladder's outside the ring. Money Manuel's after it. Fixer says, nope. Why would we want that? Yeah, you did have all damn day. Now Fixer goes after Money Manuel, puts him in the jackhammer outside the ring. Squirrel drop, Sweet Dave face first into the surface, top apron side. Jackhammer delivered on Money Manuel. All Dustin back to his feet, but Squirrel's right there waiting for him. Fixer doesn't give a crap about that ladder. Dustin thrown in the far barricade wall. Now Fixer says, oh yeah, by the way, there was a ladder out here. As Odd Dustin reverses. No, Squirrel with the reversal flips out of that hold. Delivers the knee to the midsection of Odd Dustin as Fixer puts the ladder back inside and Dr. Death to his feet, kicks away and misses at Fixer. Sweet Dave getting back to his feet. Money Manuel coming to his senses on the ramp. Fixer has a ladder, but Dr. Death drops him, picks the ladder right up, and Dr. Death says, I have some unfinished business here. And he sets the ladder back up in the middle of the ring. Dr. Death again getting ready to climb that ladder. No, he goes after Lord Eye Fixer instead as Money Manuel, the newcomer, trying to take advantage of all that work Dr. Death did. And Dr. Death takes the ladder out as Money Manuel started to climb it. Fixer goes outside the ring. The newcomer Money Manuel down inside as Squirrel, Sweet David on Dustin in that upper right corner of the apron, right by the barricade wall, continue to hammer away, and the People's Panda makes the ascent again and going up the ladder. Money Manuel right there, not letting him get much work done, grabs Dr. Death by the head. What a ladder match this is. Dr. Death says, I don't think so. Throwing Money Manuel down off the top of the ladder. And Squirrel's there as Dr. Death goes back to work on the lock. Squirrel, will he get a chance to break this up? He will. He punches at the back of the People's Panda, who still has his hands on the belt. Sweet Dave back in the ring. Fixer back in the ring. Dustin to his feet, and Money Manuel still down. Now Fixer gets some help from Squirrel. They're going to kick that. Oh, Sweet Dave was climbing it. Dr. Death caught by his Mock Potatoes tag team partner, driven down, and the ladder falls again. Is there a way to take down the belt when you hang it from the air? No. You're hanging on for dear life at that point. Dr. Death down in the ring. Dustin setting up the ladder. Money Manuel telling the People's Panda to get to his feet. Drives down into Dr. Death. And now Odd Dustin climbs. Money Manuel sees it, climbs right up there with him. And what a ladder match this is. Now Dr. Death down. Dustin taking punches from Money Manuel. Fixer and Squirrel paired off. As Squirrel sees what's going on, Money Manuel at the top of the ladder, and now Squirrel goes up behind him trying to get him down and punches away, and oh my goodness, there have been so many chances to take this belt home. Money Manuel, the newcomer, trying to get it done. Squirrel continues to punch away as Dr. Death climbs the front of the ladder again. And Dr. Death sends Money Manuel down. Squirrel trying to knock the ladder over. Dr. Death again goes to work on the lock. Will this be the time for Dr. Death? Squirrel can't get the ladder knocked over on his own and decides to go around to the front end of the ladder and climbs. Now Squirrel punches away at Dr. Death, who couldn't get it unlocked. Fixer goes back into the ring. Dr. Death getting... No, look at Dr. Death says, how many times do we have to counter at the top of this ladder? Punching away at OG Killer Squirrel, the defending champ, knocked down by Dr. Death. And now the People's Panda again has an opportunity, and Fixer's there trying to knock him off and interrupts it, and Fixer's there. Fixer has his hands on the People's Panda, pulling him down off the ladder, and Fixer gets countered by Dr. Death with a kick. Sweet Dave punching away at Money Manuel outside the ring as OG Killer Squirrel and Dustin are down. And look at this, Dr. Death dancing around. Lord Eye Fixer, punch one. Dances back and forth again. Punch two, drops Fixer. Dr. Death exhausted, can't get up the ladder. Everyone's down except Money Manuel. Dr. Death again climbs the ladder. Wants that belt. Squirrel to his feet. Sees it. Is in the ring. Can he stop him? Squirrel goes up the ladder after Dr. Death and again breaks it up. Squirrel punching away. No, again Dr. Death with the counter. But there's Fixer grabbing him by his puffy tail and slamming him down, leaving the champ on top of the ladder. What a match. Money Manuel puts the knee to the face of Odd Dustin outside the ring. The champ at the top. Dr. Death says, come on, I did all the work here. Fixer interrupts it. Throws Dr. Death out of the ring. Squirrel's there by himself on the ladder, and Fixer follows Dr. Death outside. And that's probably the end of it, as OG Killer Squirrel defends Hardcore Stalter to hell of a match, taking it home one more time. What an ending. Wow. What a match to end Friday Night Makeup Tips. Wow, nobody picked the champion. All of your tributes are gone. Wow, what a
madness.
Match.
Our old friend.
That's a great match. There's no way to go about that. That's an absolutely fantastic match. OG Killer Squirrel defends Hardcore Staltar and takes it home one more time. Alright, everybody. That was a hell of a match to call, by the way.
Take advantage of this faith-fueled charity. It will not last.
Awesome matches. Great, great, great night. We will be back in action Sunday night, 7 p.m. for our normally scheduled BOCW Sunday SmackDown, which will see Lyndon SG taking on Lord High Fixer for the Heavyweight Championship. Sweet Dave will defend Phil's Big Wheel, and again, OG Killer Squirrel will defend Hardcore Staltar. Alicia, thank you for the follow. Welcome to BOCW as we end the show tonight, but we're back on schedule. Kesselmania in the books. We got a long, long way to go before Bash of the Beast later on this summer, so we will get the cycle going again. You could look for IC next Thursday and Women's Championship a week from Sunday. Thank you for the follow, Mrs. Ducky Hugs. Hunter, glad to have you on board. Happy you like your wrestler. Happy to have you in the women's division. But thank you all for being here. We will we'll find someone to host. We've got a fairly decent crowd. You guys want to do a raid? We will do a raid. Yeah, good to see BSW back. Even though we had to shift it a day, thank you, work. But, yeah. Thank you for being here, guys. I mean, it really is that. I like doing the work as long as everyone enjoys it. I know I say that all the time, but it's only fun because people are here and we have a chat that enjoys what we're doing and reacts to the matches the way we do. Ulti finally here as the show ends. So let's go back over results real quick for those of you coming in at the end. The Dirty Little Hamster wins his debut. Ash Elizabeth wins her debut. Sask wins in the six-man battle royale in the IC. When Lyndon SG wins a shot at Lord High Fixer on Sunday. Skinja Ninja defends Mixer Chat Championship. Mads defends Mixer Chat Championship. And Squirrel defends Hardcore. I don't think that's ever happened before. More, please. Alicia, Sunday night, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Be here. We will be back with more in less than 2 days. I promise. There we go. We can do a BSCW raid. Let me go find somebody awesome to drop a host on. Give me just a second here as I lock my stream up on resources because Chrome sucks. Let's see who's going to be. Who's going to be? Who are we going to go follow? Nope. You know what? There's no one out there I want to host. Legitimately. You know what? Toofy's out there. We're trying to convince Toofy to make a wrestler. So let's get in there in Toofy with a BSW raid and convince him it's time to buy WWE and make himself a wrestler. So here we go. I know, Dr. Death. So here we go with the hashtag BOCW raid. And let's get us over to Toofy. Thank you all for being here tonight. We'll see you again Sunday night, 7 p.m. Eastern Time for BOCW Sunday SmackDown. Congrats to the winners tonight. Yeah, I'm going to have a look, Money Manuel. I'll let you know in Discord. For those of you that are interested, by the way, hit exclamation point Discord before the show ends to give you information on how to join us off stream. Get on Discord, everybody. Have a great night. We're going to drop it in on Toofy in just a second. Bye-bye.